Welcome back, fellow creators. Today's video is a bit of an odd topic, but one that desperately needs to be addressed because with the ever-increasing rapid rise of TikTok, as with any social media platform, unfortunately, it can't just be a place for good-intentioned creative entertainers. It seems that these platforms yet inevitably become another hub for scammers to dupe people online right before our eyes, and unfortunately, I wish I could say TikTok was an exception. Especially since TikTok is heavily populated by younger audiences, a lot of you who actively consume my content here on YouTube are also younger as well. And don't get me wrong, we've got an incredibly smart and talented community and we know it, but these scam artists are just getting more and more sophisticated with their methods, and after having dozens of you reach out to me asking me to cover this topic and unfortunately hearing about some of you who have been scammed already, I decided it's high time we educate the populace. So in today's video, I want to discuss the inner workings of three widespread scams on TikTok, what they are, how they defraud you, and ultimately how to avoid them as well. So if you appreciate this content, please be sure to like this video down below, and please be sure to watch this video all the way through, or at the very least, just play it in the background so YouTube knows to push this content out to more people. It is a topic that desperately needs to be addressed. So without further ado, let's begin the video and let's talk TikTok. Now, before we go any further, quick disclaimer, we're not going to be talking about any specific scams that deal with content on TikTok, such as pyramid schemes or multi-level marketing. I will say, and I'm absolutely thrilled to hear this, that TikTok recently has taken the initiative and banned multi-level marketing and get-rich-quick schemes from their platform. This is huge because not only are they the only social media platform that has actually been so bold enough to do so, finally, but it also shows more importantly that they care about the culture and are willing to protect the vulnerable from being preyed upon by false opportunities. So let's go ahead and talk about scam number one, and those are comment saviors. Now, the very first place I want to direct your attention to where this scam takes place is the battleground of the comment section below these videos. I really do appreciate every one of you trying to help each other out with TikTok advice. I try to get to as many comments as I can, but as you might have guessed, I'm not the only person trying to do so. If you take a look at the comment section below most of my videos and the comment section of other creators in this TikTok education landscape as well, you'll notice that there are hundreds of duplicate comments all promising unsuspecting victims that they have a solution to their problem. For example, I was referred to AlexGenius1 on Instagram. He's the best. He helped lift up Shadowban successful in less than 2 hours. He's 100% trusted. Hitting 1,000 followers isn't that hard. Me hitting 29 followers a year. It means you've been shadow banned. I advise you to contact CyberHelpM on Instagram. He helped me get unshadow banned and my views are increasing so fast. After lots of attempts I failed, I was able to access my account back with the assistance of CyberPoodle on Instagram. Yeah, nothing like getting your account reinstated by CyberPoodle. Luckily one of you guys caught this as a scam, so thank you for pointing that out. So many scam web apps here in the comments. Google should do a better job fighting spam. ClaimSpree is perhaps the sole web app that works for me. Every other just wasted my time with scams. Nearly all of these are simply botted accounts run by fake profiles that often will use your name to make the comment actually seem like a legit reply, make it seem highly personalized to you. In reality, they have no intention of helping whatsoever. And unfortunately, there are literally thousands of these on my videos. For example, on my How to Diagnose a Shadow Ban video, the comment section is literally entirely made up of all of these scam comments. In fact, I actually did the math, and out of over 1,800 comments on that video, over 1,200 of them are scam comments, replying basically to every single user who leaves a legitimate comment. Oftentimes, they'll even try to play the big brain game with each other by mentioning other scam comments and then proceeding to promote their own service. And what makes these scam comments so annoying, and there's been many other YouTubers that have talked about this in a similar fashion, is that they'll make little minor alterations to their words using special characters or symbols so you're not able to filter them out whatsoever. One example that I actually found was a scammer trying to spell Instagram with an N. So to show you what basically happens when you fall for one of these scams, I went ahead and reached out to a scammer, and here's the entirety of our conversation. It started, "Hi there, a YouTube comment referred me to you. I'm dealing with a shadow ban on my account." The scammer replied, "Hi dear, yes I can help. What's your username?" My response, "Oh good, my videos just aren't hitting the For You page. Username is @JosephZar. "Okay, a minute, I found your account. I think you shadow banned. I can help." My response, "I privated a lot of videos too. How did you fix it? Do you need login information?" Scammer replied, "I use software." "No, I just need 3 to 4 hours after you send payment for service." "Okay, how much does it cost?" $200, dear. "I need 3 to 4 hours. "How do I know you are legit?" "It's my job, dear. Don't worry, I promise to help you. Do you have any results?" And the scammer went ahead and sent me this screenshot of what looks like to be an Instagram DM message with no way of actually verifying this is legit. For all I know, it could have been a second account created. "Yes, dear, how do I pay you? I did that Instagram verification for that girl. I do lots of these pre-day. I will unshadow ban your TikTok. their content will not be on the For You page if you don't fix it. Do you take PayPal? We take PayPal, Bitcoin, and Western Union. Okay. How do you fix the ban? What's the software called? We will fix it. We can't share that, sorry. Our PayPal email is, and then they sent the email. My next reply, okay, I see goods and services and friends and family. Which do I choose? These are the two options that you're given when using PayPal. And this is kind of a test that I threw their way just to see how they would reply, because really a key hallmark of a lot of these scams is that they'll put you in a situation where you send them money that is irrefundable. You can't get it back. It's non-traceable, such as with Bitcoin or Western Union. And of course, them advocating for me to send it with their final reply, friends and family, dear, was just a big red flag. And I basically just stopped the conversation from there. So that's basically how they get you. They might claim that they're actively working on it, and in reality, the software doesn't do anything. There's no software that can fix a shadow ban. It's a user problem, and it needs to be an internal user solution. There are methods that we discuss on this channel that can help you successfully resolve these issues, or if you don't see a video, request it, and I can certainly make it happen. And alternatively, I would encourage you to reach out to @BJosephTodd on Instagram. He's a friend of mine. He's 100% legit. I'm just kidding, but seriously, in all sincerity, if you ever do have a question, feel free to reach out on Instagram. I don't charge a cent for answering questions over a DM. Also, please, if you notice anyone else falling victim to these scams in the comment section, let them know, link them to this video, let them know that it's an absolute waste of their time and money. Hopefully this brings more awareness that comments like this need to be called out and addressed. Unfortunately, I've seen a lot of you messaging comments like this, so I wanted to do something about it. Scam number two, TikTok phishing pages. So for those of you that aren't familiar with phishing pages, it's basically a fake web page that is set up, such as a TikTok login page, that will usually harvest your username and password, typically with the intention of stealing your account. For example, take a look at this page right here. Do you notice anything different? Well, honestly, there's virtually no difference to the real deal, but it is a phishing page and it will steal your credentials. It was actually sent to me in an email asking if I wanted verification on my profile. You know that little blue tick that you see next to usernames? I mean, let's be honest, who doesn't want that? All it requires is for me to log in and fill out a form. And I actually filled in fake login details and immediately it took me to an error page. Now, it actually should have let me know that my information was correct, which is what the real TikTok would have done. Now, I do want to mention I have been privileged to make a few contacts at TikTok over the past year, and we've actually got an interview with one coming soon here on this channel, so consider subscribing if you want to hear some inside information. But I will tell you that all of them will tell you that the platform TikTok is not going to reach out to you via email without using the TikTok.com domain extension in the email sender's address. This email with the phishing page was actually sent to me from this email right here, TikTokVerificationService1@gmail.com. Most people, unfortunately, wouldn't bother to check the email because the entire email copy in the page looks completely legit. Here's actually another example of a message, a fake message that one of our members from the Let's Talk TikTok group actually received. Again, it looks completely like a legitimate message, except the email is not from TikTok.com. Another key giveaway too is improper spelling or bad grammar. A lot of these pages are designed from scratch to look exactly like the original, and in doing so, a lot of these things are actually spelled wrong. Congratulations on your success on the TikTok app. This caught our attention and you deserve a TikTok verification badge. And they go on to say, after you apply, comma, our team will contact you through the WhatsApp application, comma, after 24 hours, comma, the authorized person will give you your badge, space, and then an exclamation mark. So please, please double check that the email is actually sourced from TikTok or that the email is associated with a certain action that you took on the platform. For example, resetting your password. You know you're likely going to receive an email if you signed up with email with a verification code for security purposes. So just make sure that you're aware of this entire process. Scam number three is fraudulent account trading. Now, a lot of you know that I'm big into building, buying, selling TikTok theme and compilation based accounts. We've actually got a video that's part of a series on that coming soon, which I'm super excited for in February. But if you know this industry at all, you know that it's riddled heavily with scammers and empty promises. Not only are a lot of these accounts actually stolen, but the seller is trying to make a quick profit on the account quickly before it can actually be returned to its rightful owner. Now, the battleground where a lot of this actually goes down is here on TikTok. In fact, scammers will claim in their account bio or username that their account is available for purchase or for sale. Message them on Instagram and they will give you the profile for a discount when they have no intention of relinquishing the profile whatsoever. So please stay away from these accounts. I've known many people, unfortunately, that have fallen victim to these traps. And I do say this as a blanket standard. It's just not worth the effort to try to weed out the bad ones to find any of these potential good opportunities if they even exist. Now, traditionally how these scams go down is they'll lure you in with some insanely good offer, such as $150 for an account with 100,000 followers, which believe it or not is an offer that's come my way once or twice in this industry. And once you send them your money, they'll end up ghosting you with no intention of ever giving you the account onto their next victim to pull the same play with them. And as much as it pains me to say it, this actually has happened to me way back in the early days of 2020. And luckily it was a very, very meager sum. It was way less than $100, but I certainly learned my lesson. And like they always say, if it sounds too good to be true, then it probably is. So please be aware that if you are in the business of buying, selling, trading, any sort of digital assets such as social media or TikTok accounts, I would strongly encourage you, unless it's someone that you absolutely trust, such as a close friend, please use some sort of escrow service online that guarantees you account delivery. An escrow service usually will use some sort of an independent middleman who will take control of the TikTok account, confirm the possession of it before the seller receives the money, and then will hand the account over to you, the buyer, once the seller receives the funds. You can check some of the escrow platforms that I've used in the past in the description down below if you're interested. Just in general, and as a rule of thumb in principle, please do not take your transactions outside of these platforms. I would also strongly recommend using PayPal as well if that is an available method of payment in the transaction. Always use the goods and services option inside of PayPal, which actually allows the buyer to retrieve a full refund if the deal goes south, and this has saved me multiple times, trust me. So as far as what can be done about all of this, I mean, there's a few options. Number one, the more educated and aware that we all are, the less likely that any one of us will be vulnerable, and the less likely that the TikTok populace will be scammed. Secondly, if you come across any more examples of TikTok scams, or maybe even more sophisticated examples of what we covered today, please let me know. These videos that I upload here to this channel aren't here to simply help you just unlock meaningful growth, but also to help you safeguard that growth as well, so that you suddenly don't lose it one day because maybe you didn't know that a login page wasn't legit. So please like this video so it does reach more users. Feel free also to take a brief moment and check out the resources free below this video as well, the TikTok Tip Offs 3.0 resource, as well as our Let's Talk TikTok Facebook group. Thank you guys so much for watching, and as always, we'll catch you in the next video. Take care, cheers.